Hi, I am Abhinav, BSc first year psychology student in Lisa College, Calicut. Here I am going to tell about mind in Vedanta. A mind is a complex of cognitive faculties that enables consciousness, thinking, reasoning, perception, and judgment, a characteristics of human beings, but which also may apply to other life forms. Advaita Vedanta is frequently criticized by Western Advaitins for its intellectual approach. Many things can be said about this, but I would like to clarify that what Advaita Vedanta means by mind. In the Westgoths, a number of functions are subsumed under the word mind. From the point of view of Vedanta, the above definitions are a bit of difference. Two flaws in the particular needs to be pointed out. The first is to do with the use of word consciousness, where normally says the mind enables consciousness, but the Vedanta says opposite. The consciousness enables mind. The other flaw is that there is no difference between all the other functions listed: thinking, reasoning, perception, and judgment. Vedanta describes the mind as the flow of thought and identifies four distinct categories of thought. The four categories are citta, memorizing; manas, emoting and thinking; ahankara, identifying with relative perception to an entity called I, that's the ego; buddhi, differentiating, discriminating, and learning. Amrutabindu Upanishad says mind is problem, mind is solution. This only makes sense in the base of the four distinct categories of thoughts. Western seekers, on the other hand, lumping all of them together, cannot but develop a deep mistrust against anything coming from the mind, which amount to the assumption that it cannot contribute anything worthwhile to the search for truth.